Hello ladies and gentlemen, SkaryTableFoot here, bringing you another Minecraft World War II vehicle tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be going ahead and building the M3 Gun Motor Carriage, abbreviated to GMC. The M3 GMC was a United States Army tank destroyer equipped with a 75mm M1897 A4 gun, which was built by the Auto Car Company during World War II. After observing the new and often decisive uses of armored vehicles on both sides during the French campaign of 1940, the US Army decided that it required a 75mm self-propelled gun, based on the chassis of the M3 half-track. This was initially known as the T-12, however after the addition of features such as a gun shield from the M2A3, the new vehicle entered production under the name M3 Gun Motor Carriage, or M3 GMC. Because the number of M2A3 gun shields available was insufficient for the M3 GMC order, a new gun shield was designed. Variants featuring the new shield were designated M3A1 GMCs. The vehicle itself first saw service in the Philippines campaign in 1942. It also saw a lot of service in North Africa in tank destroyer battalions, and was also used in the Allied invasion of Sicily. However, by this time the vehicle was obsolete and was basically replaced by the M10 tank destroyer, which did a far better job for the role the M3 was designated to serve. The vehicle itself also saw service in the Pacific Theater, and it proved effective against the lighter armored Japanese tanks, and it pretty much served through the remaining of the war in those areas. Overall, really interesting vehicle for sure, and you know, again, we did a tutorial not too long ago for the M3 standard half-track. And I mentioned in that video how awesome the M3 half-track chassis is, just because of the amount of different, basically, variants there is for it. You have different variants, you know, that obviously serve different roles. You have the troop carrier, you have the anti-aircraft versions, and you have this one right here, basically mounting a 75mm gun on it. So there's really a lot of, you know, crazy stuff, cool variants going on, and, you know, the same could be said about some of Germany's equipment and stuff like that. It's always interesting to see this one vehicle that was designed to serve one purpose end up serving multiple. So, really cool vehicle. I do really love the way it came out, and hopefully it will work for you guys in some kind of, scenarios or whatever you guys might be working on. Anyways, jumping into taking a look at the vehicle itself. If you remember back to the M3 half-track, it's pretty much using the same chassis altogether, as there's really nothing different about it. So obviously the front up here, we have the big tow cable type mount to the front here. We're working our way back. We have a different section here for the driver and passenger. So it's a bit different, obviously with space restrictions. You know, we had to change it up a little bit. Still looks good overall, and is still the same thing altogether. Overall, pretty cool looking. And yeah, that's pretty much that. As we work with back the track system, the outer siding, everything like that's pretty much all the same. The real difference comes into play when we have our basically our 75mm gun, as you can see here, mounted. We have the gun shield around it, and basically the breech and all that stuff, the gears and all that stuff to basically aim the gun. The bunch of different equipment and stuff like that back here. Then we also have the ammunition storage represented down here by some gold blocks and stone buttons. So overall, a pretty cool looking build. Definitely is cool. One of those unique kind of, you know, vehicles that, you know, you don't think of too much, but definitely is pretty cool. And, you know, can make a pretty cool addition to any of your worlds as a little support vehicle or whatever you guys got going on. Anyways, that's going to do it for this overview. Let's go ahead and move into the tutorial by beginning with our first layer. Layer 1. All right guys, moving on to our first layer, we have layer number 1. For layer 1, to go ahead and get started with, we're going to place down another brick stair that is going to basically be our right front wheel here. So we're just going to be placing down 2 narrow brick stairs upside down and back to back to each other like this. And then coming off this narrow brick stair here, we're going to place down 1, 2, and 3 stone brick top steps over, followed by another narrow brick upside down stair and 1 stair coming off of it. So basically you have your front axle here, you have your right wheel, your left wheel, and the axle that goes across like that. Coming off toward the front here, we're going to go ahead and go off the center stone brick top slab, and we're going to go toward the front 1 and 2 blocks. We're going to place down a stone brick top slab and then 1 more to the side, and it is going to be off-centered a little bit as this is this kind of mount up here in the front, so that this is off to the side by a little, so it's a little bit asymmetrical there, but that's pretty much the only asymmetrical part. Anyways, once that's done, going back from this narrow brick stair here, we're going to go and basically count back a space of 1, 2, and 3, and then we're going to place down another brick upside down stair like that. Once we have this narrow brick upside down stair here, we're going to take our dark oak wood stairs, and we're going to place down a row of 1, and two dark oak wood stairs like this, followed by another two stairs coming off the back of that stair right there. On the sides, we're going to place down a row of four of item frames with green terracotta blocks in those item frames. And we're also going to go ahead and take wooden signs and place down wooden signs on the sides of these stairs going all the way down. We then want to place down a narrow brick upstairs stair on the back here. Once that's done, we're going to go ahead and go over to this side and do the exact same thing. So again, we have a space of three blocks from this narrow brick stair to here. We're going to place down a row of one and two dark oak wood stairs. Two dark oak wood stairs come out the back of that stair. Item frames along the side here. Green terracotta blocks in those item frames. And of course, we're going to go and take signs and place down signs on the side of these stairs going all the way down like so. Once that's done, on the back here, we're going to place down a narrow brick upstairs stair like that. We then want to go ahead and place down a snow brick top set up here in the middle, followed by one and two more stone brick top sides back. So you have a row of three here. And going ahead and going to the middle stone brick top side, we're going to place down a dark oak wood fence gate coming off of it to both sides like that for this little trailer hitch on the back here. Basically, when you have that all done, you should have something that looks just like this for layer one. And that'll be the base here for the vehicle, which we'll be building upon for the future layers. So with that, that's it for layer one. And with that, we can move into our next layer. Layer 2. Alright guys, moving on to our next layer, we have layer 2. For layer 2, to go ahead and get started here, we're going to go and place down a stone brick, or two stone brick full blocks on top of these two stone brick top slabs. We then want to place down a zombie head, followed by an end rod coming off that zombie head over to the side here. Once that's done, coming off this stone brick block here, we're going to place down a dark oak wood slab, followed by a zombie head coming off of it like so. On the side of this dark oak wood slab, we're going to place down a zombie head out to the side, and on the side of this stone brick block, we're going to place down a zombie head out to the side as well. With that done, we then want to go and place down a dark oak wood stair coming off this stone brick block right here, and a dark oak wood stair coming off this dark oak wood slab. Once that's done, we're going to go and place down a dark oak wood fence gate opened up toward the zombie head here. Same thing over here, and we'll have that there on both sides. Once that's done, we're going to go and place down a row of basically just two narrow brick stairs back to back on top of these two narrow brick upstairs stairs to go and complete the wheels up here in the front. In the space in between here, we want to go and place down an end rod in between these dark oak wood stairs. We're then going to go ahead and place down a dark oak wood upside down stair here that's going to go ahead and come off of these narrow brick stairs. So like this on both sides. So just like that. And then in the middle space here, we're going to place down a spruce wood stair. Like so. Once that's done, behind this spruce wood stair, we want to go ahead and grab ourselves an anvil. And we're going to place down an anvil behind it. We then want to go ahead and go into the creative menu, grab ourselves a cobblestone wall, and on both sides of the anvil, we're going to place down a cobblestone wall. Once that's done, we're going to go and grab ourselves some green terracotta. We're going to place down a row of five of green terracotta all the way across. We then want to place down a row of three of green terracotta across, and then this time having a dark oak wood stair here on both sides, just like that. Once that's finished there, we're going to go ahead and then grab ourselves, we're going to go ahead and go to these green terracotta blocks here and place down a dark oak wood slab behind these dark oak wood stairs like that for the feet space for the driver and passenger. Anyways, once that's done, we're going to go to the sides here, place down a dark oak wood upside down stair on both sides and a green terracotta block coming off that green terracotta block there down the middle. And then to both sides here, we're going to place down a birch wood plank just like this for the seats here for the driver and passenger. Going ahead and continuing on, we're going to take our green terracotta. We want to go ahead and place down a row of five that's going to go all the way across here, followed by an item frame on both sides. In that item frame, we're going to go ahead and place down a cobweb. So it's going to be a cobweb there on both sides. With that all finished there, we're going to go ahead and then place down a narrow row of three of green terracotta across the middle here. We then want to place down a nether brick top slab that is going to come off both ends of that row of three of green terracotta. And also up here for the this wheel here on this green terracotta block, we're gonna place down a stone button on the side of it as well on both sides. Anyways, when that's done there, we're gonna place down a narrow row of three of green terracotta across. We then want to grab ourselves a end rod. We're gonna place down an end rod coming off that narrow brick top slab. Continuing on, we're gonna place down a narrow row of three of green terracotta across, followed by a dark oak wood upside down stair that's gonna go right over there on top of the stair like this. We're gonna place down an item frame on the side of this dark oak wood upside down stair, green terracotta block, and a wooden sign on the side of the stair as well. Same thing over here on this side, just like this, and it's gonna go on the side of this block, and you're gonna have your wheel right here. After that's done, we're gonna go ahead and then grab ourselves some narrow brick sides. We're gonna place down a narrow brick top slab on both sides with a row of three of green terracotta across again. We then wanna do a row of five of green terracotta across, item frame, cobweb on both ends, and a stone button. Same thing over here, as well, just like that. Once that's done there, we're going to go and then go to the green terracotta blocks here. And coming off of them, we're going to place down a dark oak wood upside down stair. And same thing over here. Dark oak wood upside down stair for the back there like that. In the space in between them, we're going to place down a green terracotta block here on both sides. And we then want to go ahead and grab ourselves a spruce wood plank and place down a spruce wood plank right here in the middle. Coming off these two dark oak wood upside down stairs, we're going to place down a green banner on both sides. And then for the middle space here, we're going to place down a lever here, coming off those two green terracotta blocks, and a dark oak wood fence gate, coming off that spruce wood plank opened up toward the spruce wood plank like that. So basically, you should have something that looks like that for the back here, and you should have something that looks just like this for layer two. As you can see, you start to have the shape coming together for the build, and everything's starting to come together. Anyways, that right there is going to do it for layer two. Let's move on to layer three. All right, guys, moving on to our next layer, we have layer three. For layer 3 to get started with, we're going to go ahead and place down a dark oak wood stair on top of these two dark oak wood upside down stairs like this for the front. We then want to grab ourselves a spruce wood stair and place down a spruce wood stair right there in the middle in between those dark oak wood stairs. To the sides here, we're going to go ahead and grab ourselves a dark oak wood slab, and we're going to place down a dark oak wood slab on these two narrow brick stairs like this, followed by an item frame on both sides and a glass block in those item frames, and also a wooden sign on the side of this dark oak wood slab as well to make the front headlights. With that done there, going ahead and going back from this, we're going to place down a row of three of green terracotta behind those stairs, followed by a dark oak wood slab to both ends of this row of three. When that's done there, we're going to place down a snow block that is going to go in the middle space right here, followed by again a green terracotta block to both sides. And then coming off this green terracotta block, we're going to place down a tripwire hook to both sides like that. With that done, we're going to place down a green terracotta block coming off the snow block in the middle, followed by a dark oak wood top slab to both sides. On the side of this dark oak wood top slab, we're going to place down a mossy cobblestone wall to both ends. We then want to go ahead and grab ourselves a spruce wood plank, and we're going to place down a spruce wood plank on top of this dark oak wood upside down stair with a tripwire hook coming off the side of this plank to both sides. With that all done, we want to go ahead and grab ourselves a wooden trap door, place down a wooden trap door on top of this birch wood stair, and have it opened up like this. Same thing right over here, just like that. In the space in between these wooden trap doors, we're going to place down a dark oak wood slab. Going ahead and continuing on, we're going to place down a green terracotta block to both sides like this after that spruce wood plank, followed by a stone button on both sides. In the middle space right here, we just want to take our green terracotta, we're going to place down a block here in the middle, followed by a mossy cobblestone wall to both sides like that. Once that's done, we're going to place down one and two green terracotta blocks along the side here, one and two. We're going to go ahead and go to the sides, grab ourselves a zombie head, place down a zombie head, and also an end rod. Same thing over here, zombie head, and an end rod back. Now for this inside section here, we do have a little bit of the interior detail we're going to start to get into. So for this, very simply, we're going to place down one and two, basically rows of two of blocks of gold. And once you have that set up there, we're going to take stone buns and place down stone buns coming off the blocks like so. On this side right here, we can go ahead and just place down green terracotta, just fill that space in like so. When that's done there, we're going to go ahead and place down a snow block to both sides like this. We then want to grab ourselves a spruce wood slab. We're going to place down a spruce wood top slab coming off the snow block to the left side. With that done, we're going to place down a row of 1, 2, and 3 green terracotta blocks back. Same thing over here, 1, 2, and 3. On the outsides here, we're going to place down a stone bun on the last third terracotta block, followed by a zombie head, and then two end rods like this going forward to connect up to that line on the side here. And same thing over here as well. So just like that. And once that's all done there, continuing to work on the inside, we're going to go ahead and place down a row of two of green terracotta coming off that spruce wood top slab, and then taking our dark oak wood slab, we're going to place down two rows of two here, like that, to fill that space in right there across from those green terracotta blocks. Now across the back here, on top of the spruce wood plank, we're going to place down a narrow spruce wood plank up like this with a tripwire hook coming off of it like so. We then want to place down a green terracotta block to both sides of the spruce wood plank. Going ahead and continuing on the back here, we're going to place down a green terracotta block coming off these two blocks in the corners here, and then we're going to take signs and wrap signs around the green terracotta blocks like this on the outside and the side facing toward the rear of the vehicle. On top of these levers, we're going to place down a end rod on both sides like that, and once you have that all complete, that will pretty much complete layer number three for the build. And with that, we're going to move on to our next layer, layer four. All right, guys, moving into our next layer, we have layer four. For layer four to get started here, we're going to go to the hood of the vehicle. We're going to place down one and two stone buns on these green terracotta blocks. Same thing over here, one and two. Once that's done, we're going to go ahead and then place down a green carpet on these two dark oak wood top slabs. After that, we're going to place down a dark oak wood fence post on these mossy cobblestone walls. And then going back from this, we're going to place down a green carpet on these spruce wood planks. With that done, in the middle space here on this green terracotta block, we're going to place down an anvil like this. Coming off the anvil going forward, we're going to take our wooden trapdoors and we're going to place down a row of 1 and 2 wooden trapdoors coming off of this anvil going forward. With that done, on top of these mossy cobblestone walls, we're going to place down a zombie head like that on both sides. We then want to place down a green terracotta block like this on both sides, and then a stone button on the side of that green terracotta block. Going ahead and continuing on, we're going to place down a green terracotta block right behind this anvil. And then to both sides of it, we're going to place down a dark oak wood top slab. We then want to go ahead and go off these top slabs to either side and place down a green terracotta block. Continuing on, we're going to place down a dark oak wood stair that is going to come off this green terracotta block right here, followed by, again, a green terracotta block to both sides. With that done, we can go and grab ourselves a cobweb, and we're also going to need to go into the create menu, grab ourselves an item frame. And for this section here, we're going to place down an item frame on the side of this dark oak wood stair with a cobweb in it like this, and also a green carpet on top of this gold block like that. Over here on the other side, we're going to place down a dark oak wood fence gate. We're going to have it opened up toward the rear, so like this. And then coming off this dark oak wood fence gate, we're going to place down an item frame and a cobweb in it like that for the gears for aiming the gun. When that's done there, we're going to place down a green terracotta block on both sides here, just like that. When that's done there, we're going to go and place down a stone button on this green terracotta block to both sides. Going ahead and continuing on, for this section here, we're going to go and place down a sign on this green terracotta block right above this spruce wood top slab. Continuing on, we're going to take our green terracotta, go back 1, 2, and 3 along the side here, followed by a stone button on the side. Same thing over here, 1, 2, and 3. Stone button on the side here, and a dark oak wood slab on these green terracotta blocks. With that done, in the middle here, we're going to place down a spruce wood plank on top of this one right here, followed by a green terracotta block to both sides of that spruce wood plank. And we're also going to place down levers on these green terracotta blocks and have them a face down to connect up to these end rods. And then on this spruce wood plank, just a stone bun like this. On the inside here, for the interior, we're going to place down a green terracotta block like this, followed by a mossy cobblestone wall that is going to be right next to it. And on this green terracotta block, we're going to go ahead and want to go into our creative menu, grab ourselves an item frame, and we are also going to need a black wool block. We're going to place down an item frame and a black wool block like this on the inside there. And over here on this side, you could do a little bit of detail as well, putting some tripwire hooks in so we can grab one and maybe do a few tripwire hooks here for hanging gear or something of that sort on the inside here. Pretty cramped space, not really much room to do much else than what we have in here, but that's basically what we have for the inside there. And anyways, once you have that all complete, that is going to wrap up layer number four. And with that, we'll go ahead and move into our last final layers, which are basically going to be layers 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. We're going to put the radio antenna on and pretty much the top of the gun and the gun itself. So with that, let's go ahead and move into our last final layers. One quick adjustment I want to make real quick with the M3 half track would be to remove this snow block and move it up one block. Now, this was originally my original design, how I had the snow block down a level, and it was something I switched out on the standard M3 half track, but I think it would look a lot better if we switched out in this case as well. It's obviously, you know, not perfect in terms of the inside here, but I do think it looks a lot better, and also for the interior here, to kind of close it off, we can put a green banner over here as well. But yeah, just I think it looks a lot better raised up a little bit. You can just kind of see it a little bit more distinctly, and you don't have the end rods blocking it or anything like that. So that's one quick adjustment I would recommend making. Obviously, you don't need to, but it is a nice little design change that does look a little bit better. Anyways, let's go ahead and move on to our final layers. Alright guys, so going ahead and moving into our final layers, we have layers 5 through 9. For these layers to go ahead and get started with, we're going to place down a dark oak wood stair that is going to go ahead and go on top of this stair, just like this on the back here. We then want to place down a wither skeleton skull that is going to come off the back of the stair, and then a wooden trapdoor that's going to be opened up next to this wither skeleton skull, so you have something looks like this for the gun breech right here. When that's done there, we're going to go and place down an anvil after this dark oak wood stair. And then coming off the anvil itself, we're going to place down a row of 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's going to be 5 dark oak wood top slabs going forward for the barrel of the 75mm gun. We can also go ahead and take this first dark oak with top slab and actually swap this out for a green terracotta block. Anyways, once this is done here, we're going to place down a wooden trapdoor closed on both sides of this green terracotta block here, followed by a wooden sign that is going to go on the side of this first dark oak with top slab here. And then after that, coming off the second dark oak with top slab, we're going to place down a wooden trapdoor closed as well, like that for the gun itself there. On top of the dark oak wood top slabs and the green terracotta block here, we can go ahead and place down a row of 5 of green carpet across the top of them, like that, to go ahead and make the barrel a little bit more green and consistent. With that done, on both sides of the anvil here, we're going to place down a green terracotta block. And then going out to the sides even more, we're going to place down a mossy cobblestone wall like this to both sides. With that done, going back from the mossy cobblestone wall, we're going to place down a green terracotta block to both sides. On the top here, we're going to place down a dark oak wood stair on top of this green terracotta block. Same thing on top of these two on the front, and also a dark oak wood stair on top of this one to the side. In the middle space in between these stairs, we're going to place down a dark oak wood top slab like this with a green carpet on top of it. It's not going to be a top slab, it's actually going to be left open like this. And then behind it, these stairs, we're going to place down a row of 3 of dark oak wood top slabs, and then on top of these top slabs, you're going to place down green carpet. So you have something that looks like that for the gun shield and all that fun stuff there. With that done, coming back to this section here, we're going to place down a zombie head on top of the snow block, and you want to make sure it's facing toward the back like that. We then want to place down an end rod, and then another zombie head on this side. Same thing over here on the right side. So just a simple little design here. And then we're going to take green carpet and place down green carpet on the remaining spruce wood planks and green terracotta on top here, just to kind of close them off and make them look a little bit nicer. And also, we're going to place down a stone button on this green terracotta block right there to kind of make that look a little bit nicer there. Once that's done, coming off the side of this wither skeleton skull, we're going to place down an end rod to the side. We also want to go ahead and grab ourselves a zombie head, place down a zombie head, come off the front of this stair right here. On the back of the stair, we're going to place down a nether brick top slab like that, come off the back of the stair. And with that all done, the last thing for us to do is just to go ahead and grab green carpet, place down a green carpet on top of this dark oak wood fence post, one on top of the green carpet here, and one on top of this green terracotta block. And same thing over here. However, this side is a little bit different. We're going to place down 1 and 2 right here, but the green terracotta block itself, we're going to go ahead and grab ourselves a dark oak fence post and also some iron bars. We're going to place down a fence post, followed by 1, 2, 3, and we're going to do 4 iron bars that go up from this dark oak fence post to go ahead and make the radio antenna. With that all complete, that is going to wrap up my design for the M3 GMC. Overall, a really nice looking vehicle and a really cool one you can add to any of your scenarios. One vehicle that is definitely overlooked, but a part of that really cool family of M3 half tracks that have really cool variants. So overall, hopefully you guys do enjoy the build. If you guys do end up using it, I do ask that you guys give me proper credit for it. This may be anything from a son of the build, link to my channel, or his video if this does appear in social media sites. As long as I get credit for the build, you're free to use it for whatever projects you guys are working on. Overall, have fun with the build and enjoy it and all that fun stuff. Other than that, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you guys all so much for watching. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This has been Geared 204, and I'll see you guys next time.